In this video, I will show you how to design and locate nanotech part of robot arm with geometry node and how to animate the part. Let's pick up with where we left off. First, change the node group name to array.main. Select all these nodes and hit right click, and you can just click collapse and hide unused socket and select these nodes and hit S and also hit Y to scale along Y direction. And then add the join geometry node and add a cube primitive. And you can change viewport shading from solid to material preview. Before going further, make a lead material like we did for gold material before. Using transform node, move the cube to one side of triangle. And add another join geometry node. Add another transform node to duplicate the first one, and we can set translation vector to 0 vector and rotate 120 degrees around the z-axis, and duplicate the second one and plug that into join geometry node. As you can see, using transform node and join geometry node, we can locate the cube at each side of a triangle. We can apply lead color to notice this easily and select these nodes and hit Command J and name this frame configuration. Now it's time to change the shape of original cube to something looks like nanopart as shown in the reference image. First, adjust the size of the original cube. And we are gonna use the mesh blend node to cut away the top corners and bottom center of the cube. As we did for configuration frame, we will use transform node to duplicate and locate cubes which will be cutting the original cube by mesh blend node. And I added switch node to check where the cutting cubes are located. Also, to cut the original cube perfectly, we can change the thickness of the duplicated cubes a little bit thicker than the original one. Well done, cutting is done. And to apply material to the cutting plane, add a set material node to the end of the configuration frame. And select all these nodes and hit Command J to make a frame and name it Design. Now we are gonna subdivide this part by using Subdivision Surface node. For this node to work properly, first of all, we should change the vertices count of the original cube and then increase the number of subdivision level until it looks moderately smooth. Because it looks a little bit thick, let's add a transform node at the end of designed frame and change the scale. Depending on your computer spec, the higher subdivision level might slow down dramatically the viewport rendering. So, Easy Viewport node is very useful in this kind of situation. After applying this node, we need to make sure it works as intended by hitting F12 to see the rendered image. Nice! We've just finished the design of nanopart, so select these two frames. Hit Command G to make another node group and name it nano.unit. After then, Ctrl C and V one of array.main. We have to click the number button to deep copy this group and let's name it array.nano. With hitting F key, we can make links between selected nodes. Also, with Command key pressed, right dragging can disconnect link. We can tab into array.nano group and substitute main unit by nano unit and change the value of multiply mass node to 1, which determines the interval between nano unit. As we did for array.main groups, we are gonna connect array.nano groups by hitting F key twice because there are two sockets on each end. Well done! We've just finished stacking nano units along the main units. Now there is only one thing left, the sequential animation like the reference video. This is why we created custom node group. Let's tab into array.nano and tab into nano.unit. With group input selected, click plus to add a new input, name it index, and hit tab to escape from this node group. Then transfer the index to nano.unit and tab into nano.unit again. First of all, add a combined XYZ node and plug this into the rotation socket of the lead transform node. As you can see, we need to change the Y-axis value to rotate each nanopart, as shown in the previous reference video. From now on, we're gonna add an important reference object for animation, the The key idea of animation is to make nanoparts rotate as this reference object move up. After letting this object move along the axis from the bottom to the top, we just use the position information of the reference object. We can bring in object info node by dragging from outliner. Here is the finished animation node. I think it'd be better to show the finished node configuration rather than adding nodes one by one. First, look at the curve with index 0 and the graph below. As the reference object moves upward, the rotation value of the nanoparts with index 0 decreases from 33 to 0 degree. I used a power mask node to make the rotation value change quadratically. Second, the index from group input serves to translate the quadratic graph to the right direction by the value of index. As a result, to make a time interval between nanounits with different indices. And last but not least, the graph should be a continuous function in order to prevent abrupt change of the rotation angle. So we have to apply the same boundary values to each node, as shown above in node configuration. There are many different ways to implement the same animation, and I think it would be nice to effectively use keyframes if possible. I recommend that you try different ways and do it your own way. As intended, nanoparts sequentially rotate while the reference object moves up and down. This is the end of this tutorial. If you have any question about this tutorial, please leave comments. And if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. It will be a great help to me. Thank you for watching this video. Bye.